So today I'm going to show you how to convert the UTM coordinates into degrees coordinates and the degrees coordinates into UTM coordinates by using Microsoft Excel. It is a very simple way. So if it is something that you want to learn, make sure that you watch until the end. And not just that, I created a Patreon link. So if you want to support my work, you want to support this channel, just go to the description below and click so as you can become the supporter or the patron. With that out of the way, let's get started. So we are going to use two tools. So the first one is the coordinate converter, Excel, this one, and also we have a sample data. So this is our sample data. As you can see, we have the degrees coordinates that we want to convert into UTM. And the other one is the UTM coordinates that we want to convert them back into degrees coordinates. Okay, so we are going to use this tool, which is coordinate converter, of course, which was created by these people or group of people, the ArchiGeeks or GeoGeeks. So credit to them for creating this amazing tool. And I'll make sure that I include the link to this template or to this Excel tool in the description below as well. Okay, so with this tool, as you can see, we have like several worksheets here. Okay, several worksheets. But as far as our story goes, we want to convert the UTM to degrees and of course decimal degrees to UTM. Now, let's get started with UTM to degrees, and let me open my sample data. Let me open my sample data. My sample data in this folder, sample. Okay, so these are the sample data. Okay, so for now, let me start with the UTM. So I want to convert this UTM coordinates into degrees coordinates. Okay, with that, let me first copy this. So before I even copy, let me show you something. The very important settings that you need to make sure that it is set correctly, it is this one. So we have two settings here. So the first one is zone. Make sure that you select the UTM zone that is suitable to you. For me, I am living in UTM zone 37. Okay, and not that I'm living in the southern hemisphere. So if you are living in the northern hemisphere, then just click this and this drop down here will appear. Make sure that you select northern hemisphere, but for me, I am in the southern hemisphere. So with that, let me copy my sample data here. Okay, I want to select only few data. Okay, yes, this 20. Let me copy this few first, and again let me go back here to my Excel tool, and then let me paste them in. Okay, so these ones here I'm not interested with. So this is where my coordinates end. Okay, this is where my coordinates end, and I don't want to copy anything below. So with these ones I am not interested. Okay, so these are the coordinates that I want to convert for now. Okay, so remember I set my zone and my hemisphere. That is very important. So as you can see, as soon as I paste my UTM coordinates, in around this area we have the decimal degrees. So as soon as I paste my coordinates, then this Excel tool converted my UTM coordinates into decimal degrees, and this is the converted decimal degrees coordinates. So let me select these ones. Okay, let me select. And again, let me open my Excel, and let me paste it somewhere here. Okay, so these were the UTM coordinates, and this is the converted latitude longitude or the decimal degrees coordinates. Okay, so another question that we need to ask ourselves: what if you have more data? But for now, as you can see, our Excel tool is limited only 30 rows of coordinates. So again, it is simple. Let me show you first. Let me show you. I want to undo. Okay. So what we need to do So for the case, if you have a lot of connects and you want to convert both of them at once, let me select both of these. So now I assume that I have more than 30 rows of coordinates. So from here, again, we are going to enter our columns into these eastings and northings. Remember, zone and hemisphere settings should be set before you even proceed. So from here, I'll just copy my coordinates in this area. So if I scroll down, you can see we have way more coordinates, but our formulas, unfortunately, we don't have. So in this area, we don't have any formula. What can we do? Can you go and just select these ones and then double click? Well, it's not work like that. What we need to do is, first thing first, if you look close around this area, you can see we have column F, G, and then we don't have column H. In a simple way, column H is there, but it is hidden. What we need to do is to make sure that we hide this column H and of course the other columns that are hidden as well. So what I can do is to double click this area. Let me double click it. Just to make sure that all of the hidden columns are hidden. So G, H. So now, so F, G, H. So each and every column now is unhidden. So what we can do now is to select these few rows and double click them. Okay, double click. So for now, if you can see here closely, it's like everything now is perfect. Okay, so if you want then to extract your degrees coordinate, you just select these ones. Okay, just let me select this. So these are the converted degrees coordinates. These are the converted degrees coordinates. Let me select both of them. Let me copy and let me open my sample data and of course paste them here. Okay, so if you can, you can even take this UTM, this altitude or elevation data and paste it there. Okay, so let me insert. These ones here are the original data. And again, these ones here are the converted data. So it is simple as that. Again, guys, just to recap, is that the first step is to make sure that you set your zone, UTM zone, and the hemisphere. So if you are living in northern hemisphere, just click this drop down menu and select the northern hemisphere. Okay, and again, if you have more data or if you have more than 30 rows of coordinates, what you need to do is the same approach. Make sure that you unhide the hidden column. Okay, make sure that you unhide them. Then after that, you go and select each and every row, you double click. Because if you don't unhide them, you will end up with very wrong answers, and that is something that you don't want to see.